Welcome to a mad scientist production of fire. We're going to use the combustion of methane, CH4, to take a look at what a flame is, to see what produces heat, connect fire to conservation of energy and energy transformations, and use all of that to understand our everyday experience with fire. Fire is a chemical change, and in chemical changes, nature favors a decrease in potential energy. This is why fire happens. Our reactants, CH4 or methane, and oxygen have high potential energy, while the products, carbon dioxide and water, have a low potential energy. But there's a bit of an obstacle here. We have that arrow telling us that the stuff on the left magically turns into the stuff on the right. But how does that happen? If we take a look at what that arrow means, what happens to make the methane and oxygen become carbon dioxide and water, then we can begin to understand what is fire. So let's take a look at that. We're going to start with one CH4 and one O2 molecule, and those are both gases which move very quickly. This is very slow motion. They're going to collide and atoms rearrange. Water forms here. So what happens when water forms? Remember that water is a very low potential energy molecule compared to methane and oxygen, but total energy is conserved. How is that possible, you ask? Two things occur that make that possible. One, when water forms, it gains a lot of kinetic energy, which we see here as high speed and rotation. And two, when water forms, water's electrons go to a lower energy state, which emits visible and infrared light. So the loss in potential energy equals the amount of kinetic energy and light energy generated. In our balanced equation, we had another oxygen molecule, so let's add another one now and see what happens as we watch the reaction proceed. The collisions produce carbon dioxide. What's going to happen next? Two things. When the carbon dioxide forms, it gains a lot of kinetic energy and emits light. And then water again forms at a high kinetic energy and emits light. So where light is emitted is where the reaction occurs. The flame, the emitted light, is where oxygen and methane are rearranging into carbon dioxide and water. The heat we feel is the high kinetic energy, CO2 and H2O, coming out of the flame. Our nervous system gets upset when those high-speed particles hit our skin, transferring their kinetic energy to the molecules in our skin. Before moving on, let's get a quick summary of what's going on here. We have high potential energy, CH4 and O2, producing low potential energy, CO2 and H2O. That difference in potential energy is transformed into kinetic energy and light energy. The total energy does not change. Our reaction obeys the law of conservation of energy. Let's expand the idea of heat a little bit more. Heat is carried by the high kinetic energy, water and carbon dioxide. The heat transfers to the air and eventually dissipates. Why does that happen? Well, the high kinetic energy carbon dioxide and water collide with air particles. Heat dissipates as particle collisions transfer that initial kinetic energy to larger and larger amounts of air particles. The farther you get from the flame, the less heat you feel as that initial kinetic energy gets dispersed and diluted among all those air particles. Everything we've been talking about here can be applied in general to just about any fire you encounter. CH4 is what is called a hydrocarbon, and hydrocarbons provide the fuel for almost any fire you might see. Hydrocarbons are any compounds made out of carbon and hydrogen. There are many, many hydrocarbons that we encounter, such as natural gas, and methane is the largest component of natural gas, so that's what you see burning on your stove, as well as waxes, petroleum products such as gasoline, and when you burn them, they produce carbon dioxide and water and light. Hydrocarbons can also be somewhat oxidized, including carbohydrates and lignin, which incidentally are the two major components of wood, and there are also fats and alcohols. And when you burn them, you produce carbon dioxide and water and light. So hydrocarbons are the fuels used in any fire you would normally encounter in your life. The formation of carbon dioxide and water is what produces light, which is the flame, and carbon dioxide and water are the predominant carriers of heat in any fire you would normally encounter in your life. And that is the story of fire.